Let's go back. And beg my pardon. We lived atop a Broadway, had a big garden. Good memories, it was council, felt like a mansion. Big bro says he saw a ghost in the rocking chair. Bit like our granddad, at the time he did swear. Now he's not so sure, but I think that's fair. Grief can cause the mind to imagine what's not really there, yeah. But other brother running round, raving in fields, chewing his face off, spinning his turntable wheels. We're on the breadline when it came to bills. What mum did takes true skills. It was in the era of the phone or telly. Own one we could afford, well barely. Thanks to the English red box, the answer was clearly the TV. What would it have been like to grow up without Eastie's? Then it led on to the Sega, not Mega, but the Master. Sonic opened my world up to a new adventure. I jumped from Beano to the old bestseller. This is when tech started to fuse together. East school's on the weekday, then we could Sarnie's paint day. No Peggy, this is on Queensway. Pretty much all I remember till Saturdays. My grandmother would bring me chocolate, chatting about everything as we walked to the market. A bunch of Smarties were her mum met. I'd watch the meat van with the ham packet. Sundays was the day of the family roast. Everyone came, I'd wake Daniel up with tea, Vince, Rose. Vince would sing that Pasquale song that gets on your nose. Years later, I realised it's nerves in a high note. Did he sing it wrong? Who fucking knows? The evenings was the time to talk to Nan. She and me uncle Rex lived down in Grantham. Unlike us, they had a phone plan. But nothing beat holidays with the whole clan. Till then, mum pushed me down to the town box so we can narrow up our socks. Like I said, we saw them Easter's, Christmas, and not a lot. Till I'd get bored and cry, causing mum to shout. Time to breathe.